So we are back in the Ionian Islands, and while this is going to be brief, I am really pleased to have snuck this one in. Originally, we visited Corfu, and then a few months later, combined Kefalonia and Zakynthos into one trip. So we had a little mini-series going there, and those three are definitely the most well-known of the Ionian Islands. However, we just missed out on catching Lefkada. I had hoped to take a day and get there from Kefalonia, but we were staying in Argostoli, which is in the south, and without getting into the boring details, it's not 100% impossible, but I wargamed it out, and when you've got a link, a very limited Kefalonia bus timetable, a handful of ferry departures, and very limited Lefkada buses, it was just not going to work as a day trip in any practical sense, so we just dropped it. However, since then, by a fluke of pricing, I managed to get flights into Preveza for less than the cost of a £41 sandwich. And I mean, I very rarely pay more than about 40 quid a flight as it is, but £40 for there and back, like all in. And while I had only 48 hours to do it all, it was the least I could do to satisfy my curiosity. So, bit of context. Geography boffs will have already noted all my omissions from the Ionian Islands playlist. No Paxos. We looked into that when we were on Corfu, but stop me if this sounds familiar. The boats were timed in such a way to make a day trip impossible, so you'd have to stay at least a night, so that got dropped. No Ithaca. There didn't seem to be a super ton of unmissable stuff there. See also no Meganese. So basically none of the outlying islands. It did seem like there was little you'd get from these smaller islands that you weren't already getting from the main Ionian Islands, with the possible exception of Paxos, which does have a couple of cool things going on. Apart from standing out in size, it's these four that have an airport, but Lefkada is a little bit different. It's definitely the least famous of the four, and it's also close enough to the mainland that it is in fact connected by road. Its airport is on the mainland. It's sort of a split custody between Lefkada and the somewhat closer city of Preveza, though to confuse you further, the airport is actually named after the tiny village of Actian nearby, which is a bit like naming Gatwick Hawley Airport, but yeah, whatever. So right before you reach Lefkada by road, you are greeted with this. Yeah, you probably guessed the real reason I wanted to tick Lefkada off the list already. Does it have a Venetian fort? Yeah, that would be a Venetian fort there. So it's pretty impressive in size. You can see most of it from the road. It's €2 in, but a spectacular pointless rule. They are currently forbidding photos inside while work goes on, or rather while a few workmen stand around. It's not an embarrassingly bad state or anything. I sneakily filmed a few bits in there anyway, because, well, grow up. Unless you've unearthed a Stargate in there, then what on earth are you fussing about? Oh, and by the way, in the marshes, just before you get to the fort, and apologies, this isn't better footage, but flamingos. Yeah, whole flocks of them. They're gone by about 10 a.m, but if you get there early, both of the mornings I was passing, there were flocks of them just chilling there. Anyway, the fort stands at a strategic entry point to the waters east of Lefkada, which, considering the marshes and sandbanks, both natural and man-made in the area, is only a few metres wide. It's currently bridged by this interesting bridge ship thing that sort of periodically sounds an alarm and raises the bridge and pivots out the way to allow boats to pass. Beyond that, there's a breakwater. It's not entirely dissimilar to the Bosset on Kefalonia, but a little bit less pretty and kind of longer. And then you're in Lefkada town. Well, what's it like? It's quite nice. As a UK resident, that's always a weird question to answer when it comes to Greece, because the scale is just completely off. Fast forward to the following morning, and I'm sat on the edge of a car park. Not a designated beach, just a car park that's next to the water. And I'm thinking, there is just nothing in England that is this beautiful. Now I'm going to get in trouble for saying that, but just by English standards, it's paradise. By Greek standards, yeah, it's not the best we've been to, but it's quite nice. It reminded me of Argostoli. It's all, yeah, like, yeah, nice, but without any major highlights. I mean, being surrounded by mountains and clear blue waters is kind of a highlight, but I imagine the historic town might have been a lot more historic before the 1953 earthquake did a number on it. I can't give you a detailed breakdown of the entire island because, well, there just wasn't enough time to get further inland. Understand, the bus connections on Lefkada are, yeah, very sparse. It's an island of high mountains and small villages outside of Lefkada town. I'd wanted to at least get as far as Nidri, but I wasn't going to be able to do it without pretty much taking almost a whole day out, and within the 48 hours, that would have meant me missing this, and this. Back to Lefkada town. Despite being quite sleepy for the major town of the island, it still, of course, boasts way above average coffee because, well, we're in Greece. Of course it does. I think this is a local outlet. It's hard to tell, but it has a really well-balanced cup. I had to get myself a coffee island. That's pretty much a sacred rite whenever I'm in Greece. And this spot was also really good. Great flavour, but with a good balance of the sharper tones. Other than that, as far as Lefkada town goes, there's a scattering of hotels, shady back streets, and more yachts than actual buildings. So look, I did say it would be brief. There's not much more detail I can give you on Lefkada. I'm skirting around a lot of the waypoints of my trip as I was actually staying nearby in Preveza. Preveza is, again, not dissimilar enough yachts to relocate the entire population of Sri Lanka. It has the sort of silhouette of a historic town, but without the original architecture to go with it. The town has a nice-ish waterfront, but most of the town is arranged around just one straight road, which goes out the north of the town and goes on for basically ever. It's actually separated from the airport by this 500-meter channel, but there's an underwater tunnel that links the two. But I'm going to put the brakes on there because this is mainland Greece and this is all starting to seem a bit like mission creep. What I will say is Lefkada, the island, may not have a lot of sites to specifically aim at, but since you can drive on and off, it's a good point to explore the surroundings. Preveza, the town, isn't all that special as Greek towns go, but just out the north is Nicopolis with Roman ruins for days, and that is well worth a look. The other recommendation I have, a little to the east of Lefkada, is the town of Vonitsa. It's very beautiful. It's not really set up as a tourist town, but it's where... Okay, would it shock you to your very core if I told you it had a Venetian fort? Still, I stand by my suggestion. This is a beautiful little town to spend at least a day, maybe longer. Slight word of warning though, as I already intimated, trying to string my itinerary together with the buses was like trying to milk a salmon. And it's made more hilarious by... Okay, quick word on Greek buses. The buses are all run by KTEL, whether you're on Crete, Corfu, or... need another C to complete the alliteration. Athens. Just nailed it. Thing is, despite the familiar KTEL logo, these are actually local franchises which all have their own websites and timetables. And Lefkada town sits on a tri-point border between three of these. There's KTEL for Lefkada the island, there's a different KTEL for Preveza and the rest of Epirus, and then a different company again for Aetolia slash Akarnania. Akarnania? Yeah, that one, which is where Vonitsa is located. And since it's not so much of a tourist spot, that particular website is not available in English, so have fun squinting at the Greek names. It's not too bad, you'll get used to swapping letters around. Be warned, if you want to ditch the buses and just get cabs, you'll rarely get much change from 30 euros. The cab drivers were actually quite genuinely lovely, you know, really friendly and with an impressive conversational English, but yeah, it's a bit of a jump from the 3 euros to bus from Lefkada to Preveza, so just keep that in mind. So that's all from Lefkada. I know that making recommendations on an island where I only saw the capital is not the best piece of travel writing, but hey, scratching that incessant completionist itch did feel really great. I wouldn't make it a top priority of the four Ionian islands with airports. There's gotta be a better way to say that. But hey, if like me you find some October flights there for 41 quid, or as it's best known in the UK, the cost of a 15-minute train journey, you definitely won't have a terrible time. And because you are not me, you won't pack your shooting schedule inside 48 hours and you'll make sensible choices about your transport. I'm going to leave you with one final tip. Take earplugs. Now, I know this was technically in Preveza, but even though my Airbnb was nice enough, I was being harassed by crickets. Or more specifically, one cricket. You see, a chorus of crickets is a nice sound. It's quite relaxing as a soundtrack to your night, and I'm very familiar with it as it's the sound I hear every time I make a joke. But one cricket on its own, I don't know if this was some sort of alpha cricket with unusually loud hind legs, but it genuinely sounded like a smoke alarm was running in the next room. And when it's just one cricket, it might as well be Lucifer himself playing a violin through a DS1. I genuinely had to do this balancing thing with two pillows over my ears like this was a panel from the Beano just to get any sleep. And it did not let up the entire night. Take earplugs, kids. Oh, and check out the EP. We'll be catching you for the Kefalonia episode. See you soon.